Okay, now that we have Mux Player set up, let's start customizing the look and feel of the player. First things first, we might want to customize the poster image. The default poster image will be the midpoint of the video, which is the default thumbnail that's returned from the Mux thumbnail API. If we want to change that a little bit, we can pass in this thumbnail time attribute. So let's say I want the thumbnail time from the 5 second mark. We can do that, and that'll be the thumbnail from 5 seconds, or let's say I want the 22 seconds thumbnail time. Can do that. Now it'll be the thumbnail from 22 seconds. So that's handy when you want the poster to be from a frame from the video itself. If you have a completely unrelated image that you want to use from the thumbnail, you can do that as well with the poster attribute. So you can say poster equals, and you can pass in a URL pointing to an image and use that as your poster. So that's the way to that's a way to customize the thumbnail. Next is, let's say you have a brand color that you want to use and you just want to kind of theme the player according to your brand. We call that the primary color attribute, so you can pass in that. I have this orange color here I can use, and now that'll theme all the controls in that primary color. You can see how that works. What else can we do here? Oh, we can add a video title. So pass in here, title equals my Mux video. Pass in a title that'll show up in the top left. So that's handy. And then the thing about Mux Player is because it is just a plain HTML web component, we can style this thing with CSS, just kind of like you would style any HTML element. So let's give this some style here, and let's give this Mux Player. So let's select it, and then let's say width 100%. Max width 500 pixels. Let's give it a display block. By default, it's inline blocks. So let's give it a display block, and then margin 40 pixels at the top and auto on the sides. So that way it'll be kind of nice and centered my page. Refresh this. Okay, so now you can see it's centered here directly in the middle of the page. And see, I'm just using normal CSS to style this. Now let's say for my particular video, I don't care for some of these controls. Let's say I don't want users to have the control to adjust the playback rate, for example. What I can do here is we have some CSS variables for showing, for, you know, controlling the display value of these. First of all, dash dash controls none, that'll just hide all of the controls. So I do that. And now you can see there's no controls here. Well, that's not exactly what I want. So let's say, so let's undo that. Okay. These are the controls available. So there's the pip button. Which one do we want? Okay, let's say the seek back, the rate, playback rate. Where is playback rate? Playback rate button, none. So copy that one. Let's do that. And let's say I also want to disable the seek backward and seek forward buttons, because maybe I just have a short video here and, you know, my users don't really need to seek. I can just hide that. You can see the playback rate control is gone. The forward backward controls are gone, but I still have everything else. So it's easy to just kind of customize the feel with CSS. Now, if you really want to get into it, you can hide. You can see that these controls, how they kind of, they jump around depending on the size of the container. Oh, I have a max 500 pixels. Let me increase that. Let me make this 1,000 pixels. Okay. So you can see that, you know, sometimes the controls are at the top or at the bottom, depending on the screen size. So you can really get granular to control if you only want to hide this control when it's on the bottom, but you're okay with it being on the top, then you can control that with these CSS variables. Mux Player also exposes CSS parts so that we have some documentation here. So you can really kind of control the CSS of the specific parts that are exported. And that's kind of a native web component kind of pattern that we use to expose pieces of the player for styling. The controls backdrop color, so you can control that. That one you have to be a little bit of careful with, because there is a contrast ratio requirement for accessibility. So be careful changing that around. You don't want to make it, if you get rid of it completely, then the controls won't be visible from an accessibility standpoint. So primary color and secondary color, we talked about that. And now when you want to kind of change the default behavior, MuxPlayer pretty much supports the attributes that the video element supports. So muted, for example, I can pass muted here for the player to start off. Muted, you can see it's muted. Oftentimes people want to autoplay video, so the autoplay attribute, as you can see, it's muted and it's autoplaying. Autoplay can be a little tricky, so we actually kind of extended the autoplay attribute for the purposes of Mux Player, so where you can pass in autoplay equals muted to just always autoplay the video in a muted state. That's often what you need to do, because browsers will not allow you to autoplay with sound in most cases. We also have the autoplay any value, and that means that it'll try to autoplay with sound. If that fails, then it will fall back to autoplay muted. We have that behavior documented here. If you want to loop the video, for example, like let's say you have a video that's playing in the background of your web page and it's looping, then you can do loop autoplay muted. So now it'll autoplay muted and it'll loop. And then let's say if it's just playing in the background, maybe you don't want controls. So now you can say controls none. So now that should give me a player that has no controls and it's just going to autoplay muted in the background. Sometimes you may want that if you're, you know, have like a hero video that takes up the entire top section of your video page. So that's all the different ways, at least some of the ways that you can customize Mux Player. Let's make sure this loops at the end. You can see it, yeah, start looping. We have keyboard shortcuts enabled by default. That works when the player or any of the controls has focus. You can turn that off with no hotkeys. Then the other thing when it comes to kind of customizing Mux Player is that you get the JavaScript events at the regular HTML5 video element fires off. So let me get rid of this. Let's kind of go back to the default player, and I can write some JavaScript here where Mux Player equals document.query selector Mux Player. MuxPlayer.addEventListener, and let's just go HTML5 video events. Okay, so here are the events that fire for HTML5 video. Playing. Let's look at the progress event. So I can add the progress event, and let's just log that to see what we get. Okay. Let's make that muted again so I don't have to hear that. Cool. Okay. So you can see that progress event is firing in that callback that I registered. So now I might want to use that progress event to track a user's progress through the video and maybe save their progress into my database or something like that. So all of these events that you get on the HTML5 video element, these are all baked into Mux Player. You'll see the same ones firing. So you can just add event listeners. All right, that is some of the basics of customizing Mux Player.